Greetings everyone. Look at these three sentences. God save us. I demand that He do something to solve the issue. And the third sentence is, it is advisable that she read the rules. What do you feel about these three sentences? When you think about the normal way of writing English, you may find some strangeness in these three sentences. Take the first sentence, God save us. God is singular in form, and if the subject is singular, the verb should also be singular. But here, the sentence is used only the base form of the verb. Why? And here, I demand that he do something. He do something. We have learned from our school days onwards that after he, we have to use the singular form of verb. But here we use the plural verb do. Why? He do something to solve the issue. He plus the base form of verb. Why? Look at the third sentence. It is advisable that she read the rules. Here also, she read the rules. Usually or normally we have to say she reads the rules. Can you find any mistake in these sentences? No. These sentences are grammatically accurate and exact. They are too formal in structure. Grammatically, this is correct sentences. So what is behind these sentences? Let us check. So today's lesson is on the subjunctive mode of verb. What is the subjunctive mode of verb? It is very essential to know what is subjunctive mode and how does it work in English grammar. We use the subjunctive when talking about events that somebody wants to happen, anticipates will happen, imagines happening. So this subjunctive mode of verb is used when somebody wants to happen something, or he anticipates something will happen, or imagines that something is happening. Use of the subjunctive in certain that clauses. That is what we are going to learn today. The use of subjunctive cases in certain that clauses. Look at here. The base subjunctive is typically used in that clauses after two structures. So here we are talking about the base subjunctive. Base subjunctive here means root verb. The use of root verb with all the subjects, first person, second person, third person, and third person plural. With all these subjects, whether it is in singular or plural, or in past or future or in present, we use root verb with certain verbs. We have to learn those verbs in English to use this subjunctive mode. First, certain verbs that suggest something. Verb form or noun form. Then plus that. The rest of the sentence carries the subjective mode. Look at these words: advise, ask, command, demand, desire, insist, order, prefer, propose, recommend, request, suggest. All these verb forms, when we use with a subject and this verb form plus that, then we have to use the subjunctive form, the root verb form with all these subjects. Look at the noun form of these verbs: command, demand, order, proposal, recommendation, request, suggestion. All these noun forms also we use after these noun forms with the that clause, the subjunctive form. When we learn the examples, it will be clear for you. Now, the second structure is words related with advice or anxiety. Advisable, anxious, adjectives. The adjectives related with advice or showing our anxiety, then plus that. Look at the words: advisable, best, crucial, desirable, essential, imperative, important, necessary, unthinkable, urgent, vital. Then adamant, anxious, determined, eager, keen. You have to remember all these verb and nouns and adjectives to know where we have to use the base subjunctive form of verb. Look at the examples. Look at these sentences which include examples of the above. Here the main clause and here the that clause. So here the words are related with a suggestion. Suggest something, verbal form. Look at the first sentence: he suggests that. Look at the word suggest that. You be present at the meeting. Look at here. He suggests that you be present at the meeting. You plus be. You be present. Can you imagine that this can be used in normal English? No. In normal English, we have to use that you will be present or you should be present. In normal English, we have to use you should be present or you will be present at the meeting. But here, as these words are used, suggest that, we are forced to use the subjunctive form of verb. The subjunctive form is be. Look at the second sentence. The board recommend that. The board recommend that. The board is considered here as a plural noun, so recommend. That he joined the company. Look at here. He plus join. He joined the company. In normal English, we can't use he join, but he joins. Or we can say that he should join. He should join the company. But as the main clause contains recommend that, we are forced to use the subjunctive form of verb. Look at the third sentence. He requested that. Another word, request. He requested that the car park not be locked at night. Here, in normal English, it is not possible the car park not be locked at night. Either we have to add some modals here like should. The car park should not be locked at night. But when we use these words like suggest, recommend, requested, we are forced to use the subjunctive form of verb. Here is the subjunctive form. The car park not be locked at night. Look at the negative form used here, not be, not. Use it after be plus not. Don't use be not. It should be not be locked or not be closed before night. Let us check another set of words. They made a suggestion that, this word suggestion, and the connector that. So naturally we have to use subjunctive clause. VBALE. They made a suggestion that VBALE. VBALE. In normal English we can say that we should be ALE. But as the word of suggestion comes here, we have to use the subjunctive clause in English. That is, they made a suggestion that we be ALE. Look at the next sentence. He made a proposal that the company buy more land. The company is singular. Naturally, we have to use buys. But here, buy, the subjunctive base form of verb. Because here, we used in the main clause the verb proposal that. In the same way, the president has issued an order that the secretary resign next month. So here also we use the subjunctive clause because the word order. So you have to remember all this list of words like a suggestion that, proposal that, order that. These are nouns. So when we use these words as nouns or verbs, we have to use the subjunctive clause. The subjunctive clause in all these sentences to make it more formal. There is no wrong in using should along with these words. Should is used mainly with British English. But in American English, they never use this should or any modal between these two words, the subject and the subjunctive modal verb. In British English, they use mostly should. That is the difference between American English and British English. But in British English also, this is used. This is considered as the correct English usage, the formal usage of English. But nowadays in British English, they use the modals like should to avoid that awkwardity in the usage. Let us check another set of words. It is advisable that she rest for a week. Here also the base form, the subjunctive mood is showing here. It was essential that. So these phrases, it is advisable that, it was essential that the army advanced rapidly. Here the base form is used. After the landing, it will be vital that. So it will be vital that every soldier not use a radio. The subjunctive form or the base form of the verb is used here. Look at another set of. Tara is anxious that you return soon. They are keen that he not be hurt. We were determined that it remain secret. So these words, anxious, keen, determined, after all these verbs, after all these adjectives, we have to use the subjunctive form. Tara is anxious that, they are keen that, we were determined that. Then look at the that clause, that you return soon, that he not be hurt, that it remains secret. Here we use the base form of the verb. Now let us check the past subjunctive. The past subjunctive may be used after if or I wish to express regret or longing. Example, if your father were alive, he would help you. If your father were alive, this is the subjunctive form of verb. If I were rich, I would buy a Ferrari. I wish I were taller. If only he were. Here now. So in past form, we use were with all the subjects. Whether it is first person, second person or third person, no matter. We have to use were in past subjunctive forms. Because these are impossible things that we are telling. If I were rich, I would buy a Ferrari. I wish I were taller. If only he were here now. All these are assumptions. So where are we can use this subjunctive form? If you want to talk or write about a wish or a request or a demand that has not happened yet, you can use the subjunctive mode. That is why we use the subjunctive mode of verb in English. Look at this. The mood here means form. Form of a verb used to refer to actions that are possibilities rather than facts. So here we are talking only about possibilities, not about the facts. Look at this sentence. I wish I were rich. I wish I were rich. The verb where is the subjunctive. Here, where is used as subjunctive. I wish I were rich. Only possibility, not fact. That's why we use the subjunctive mood. I wish I were rich. Because I wish, after wish, we always use the subjunctive verb of were. Now let us check the present subjunctive. Look at the difference between these two sentences. He plays cricket. It is an indicative mode. That is a statement. He plays cricket. But look at the second sentence. I suggest that he play cricket. This is subjunctive mode. Why we use only play here?
The answer for that question is because we used the verb suggest. I suggest that. I suggest that he play cricket. So if we use verbs like suggest or advise, request, we have to use the base form of the verb along with that clause. That he play cricket. Look at the next sentence. Vaccines are discovered to contain the pandemic. This is indicative mode. Vaccines are discovered to contain the pandemic. Look at the subjunctive mode. It is recommended that. Look at the word recommended. When we use the verb recommended and that, it is recommended that vaccines be discovered to contain the pandemic. Not vaccines are discovered. Not vaccines are discovered, but the base form of are or is or am is be. We use that be here. Vaccines be discovered to contain the pandemic. This is called the subjunctive. So this be verb here is subjunctive. The same sentence we can write in another way also. It is recommended that the vaccines should be discovered to contain the pandemic. This much is for today. If you like the video, please share it with your friends and press the bell icon. If you like and if you demand more such videos on grammar topics, please subscribe the channel and press the bell icon. Thank you for watching till the end. Don't forget to share it with your friends.